me tell you about the law.
The law of physics is what I'm talking about. Remember that last explosion that was supposed to be a propane bottle rocket? Well, anyways, it didn't work in one way, but it sure was spectacular in another way. Let me teach you guys a few things about what actually happened there. I find it fascinating. First of all, the law of physics says that water expands 1,700 times its original volume when you turn it to steam. Well, that's true, but I'm sure they're measuring that at atmospheric pressure, like 14.7 psi, at 100 Celsius or 212 degrees Fahrenheit. Well, in that pressure vessel, while it's being heated, the temperature gets way past the boiling point. So when that thing actually bursts open and all the water turns to steam, then we get a spectacular result. I'm sure it expands way more than 1,700 times its original volume, because the steam is much hotter than water could ever be, because there's no limit in the temperature that you can make steam. And so the hotter you make something, the more the molecules or the atoms expand. At the end of this video, I've attached the explosion, which wasn't supposed to happen, but was fun, played really slowly, so you can exactly see what's happening. At first you see the explosion. You see two projectiles going off in angles like this, and that's the two halves of the cylinder. It split open like this, and then continued on in that direction, thus vectoring all the thrust towards the ground and making the crater. The next thing you'll notice is that there's two explosions. The second one actually sounds maybe a tiny bit bigger than the first one. Listen carefully, you may have to watch it over and over again. And the second explosion is just a millisecond past after the first explosion. So I'll explain what's happening. When the first one goes off, you have this volume of steam, which displaces all the air that used to be there. So now it's just steam in that void. And then immediately the steam cools. Expansion of anything creates cooling. Plus the steam was just released to the neutral environment, which is also has a cooling effect. Well, immediately the steam turns back into water or water vapor or water droplets or whatever it turned into. And now there's a big vacuum in the space. So at the pressure of air, 14.7 psi, it all rushes in at the same time and collapses. Now, we can all see this every day, like when we're boiling a coffee and the kettle starts to like pop, make little snapping sounds as the water gets close to boiling point. Well, exactly the same thing's happening there. Steam bubbles are forming very close to the heating surface, but then they, since they're less dense than water, they release themselves from the heating surface and then go in cooler water. Then they have a sudden collapse. This is very powerful, and that little tiny bubbles, like only a millimeter big, can make a loud snap that you can hear right through all that water. Interesting. It's actually so powerful that it can cause cavitation on the surfaces of things. For example, if a propeller on a boat is spinning too fast in the water, it becomes very inefficient because it makes vacuum bubbles behind it, and they're collapsing, or vacuum bubbles right behind the leading edge of the blade, and they're collapsing too, and that's cavitating your blade, putting little pock marks, little holes in it, and eventually it erodes your blade. Yeah, just water. Well, keep watching that video, and you'll notice that the shockwave from that video is moving across the ground. Now, of course, all shockwaves move similar, but it seems to be moving at about, I would say, 30 or 40 feet per frame. Well, the camera took 30 frames per second because it's not a high-speed camera, so you get an idea if you want to calculate the speed of the shockwave. And the shockwave seems to only last about 3 frames. Well, then you'll notice that the dust it's created as it's moving across the dirt ground, all of a sudden the dust is going in reverse, like after a nuclear bomb, and everything's getting sucked towards the center. Well, after a nuclear bomb, it's just because there was so much heat and then there was less heat. This is a little bit different. This time there was a bunch of heat, a bunch of steam, then the steam disappeared. So now we had a vacuum. The air all collapsed again and created a suction towards the propagation point of the explosion. And then you can see long after, with several frames, the dust all moving and going towards the center point of where this event happened. Very, very interesting. Of course, if this was an explosion that had to do with explosives or anything else like that that produces gases from a solid, it still would have a little bit of the reverse flow effect of the air, but nothing as extreme as happened with that steam explosion. So I think the steam explosion is probably the most awesome explosions I've ever made in my life, even though I wasn't attending on it. And it certainly has that double explosion, and I'm almost thinking that the secondary explosion is more powerful than the first one. Best way to enjoy this video, at least the last part of it, is to have your stereo, if your computer is hooked to a stereo system, on full bass, half treble, maybe a little bit more treble, full volume, and crank it. The bigger speakers, the better. And you can really hear things really well. If you're listening to this on a handheld device or just crappy little plastic computer speakers, you'll never really appreciate what I'm talking about. Sounds almost like a Hollywood explosion. Enjoy. Watch the second part.